the police officers told Andy something very important.
What was that?
Well, they said that they had extensive, one of the officers said that he had extensive experience with special forces. And after interviewing Catherine, they asked her if she wanted to see her father. And she indicated no. But he said that he told me, the police officer told me that he was a specialist in body language, that Catherine's entire, her entire body was indicating nonverbally, just the opposite of every word that she was saying.
Well, you know, it's very interesting that you say that, because I am very trained in the same regard, and I've been looking at some of the video of your daughter, and I have to tell you that my comment to my staff is that some of this looks very much like a prisoner of war video to me, where you see sometimes Americans that are being held hostage, and you have what we call pushed verbalizations, where in normal conversation there's a flow where one word triggers the next word, and that's how you have flow in a dialogue. When you're not really expressing your own feelings and your own thoughts, that doesn't happen, and so you have to operate on each word individually, and so it becomes pushed. And when you hear her talking, she's having to pull up each word, and it's not that she doesn't think she's doing it voluntarily, but it doesn't flow. Mm-hmm. And that's what happened when someone has surrendered their will and they're not talking in a way that comes from their own thoughts, their own feelings, their own heart.